Avery Rusika of Manresa Bread is our guest today. Manresa Bread is located in Los Gatos.
I'm here with Avery at Bite Silicon Valley, the first conference on food and technology. And Avery is a bit of a celebrity in our part of the world because of Manresa Bread. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
So Manresa, we all know the restaurant. Yes. How did the Manresa Bread concept come about?
I started making bread at Manresa restaurant, for the restaurant, and we had such a positive feedback from it. And also, I love baking so much that we were given the opportunity to start baking our bread at the Campbell Farmers Market, kind of as a give it a try, see how it goes. And it went really, really well. And so from there, we were able to open at the Palo Alto Farmers Market after another year. And then another year, we just opened our new shop, our own shop.
I'd like to get your thoughts about bread in the Bay Area. Excepting for South Bay, maybe Manresa Bread and maybe Acme, which has its production facility in Mountain View, it looks like San Francisco and the East Bay are home to some huge bread trends.
Yes.
What do you see?
What am I seeing trend-wise? Well, I think for sure everybody's still super excited about ancient grains. You know, everybody's kind of asking all these questions. What does that mean? Really high hydration doughs, long fermentation times, which are all wonderful. I'm a big believer, though, in bread kind of being an extension of the people making it. So if you're more excited about a white bread, I think then that's the kind of bread you should eat. You know, I think the trends are exciting because they're about bakers or chefs asking questions and wanting to try something new, learn new techniques, deepen their knowledge by trying something different. But at this end of the day, you need to be making something you enjoy eating or you enjoy sharing with other people. So trends are great, but the trends are only great if they help you kind of actually make what your, you know, your offerings more interesting, more valuable to yourself and to others.
How do you get it in this shape? My bread never comes out looking like this.
Frequently we'll use something like a basket, a lined basket, such as this. This one has a little bit of rye berries in it to show our guests, but and that helps support the dough while it's doing its final proof, which is going to help you maintain a really nice shape until you bake it. Yeah, so all of our doughs, though, are sourdoughs, so they're going to be, we ferment things overnight in like a cold area. So this helps keep the shape while we do the fermentation, and then we take it out of the basket and we bake it.
Any other baking tips?
I think just kind of go with your gut. Have fun. Don't be afraid to get your hands dirty. I think people are really tentative about dough, and dough is not that sensitive. When I watch people first trying to, like, work with dough, I think a lot of times they're afraid to, like, hurt it. And it's kind of like, even in the worst case, if you're a little rough with your dough, you can kind of let it rest and you can reshape it usually. Like, it's not as delicate as it seems. Yeah.
What does it feel like to be at Levi's Stadium?
It's really exciting. I've never been here before, and it's beautiful. So this has been a really fun event. I mean, it's a beautiful day. The stadium is gorgeous. So it's a lot of fun.
Are you a football fan?
I'm not a football fan.
Oh, so you're not ready for next year's Super Bowl?
Not. I mean, my friends are, so I'll get on board with them. But I'm not a big football fan. So, but maybe I'll learn. Maybe this inspires me. So.
What is Manresa Bread going to be doing for Super Bowl 2016?
Gosh, Super Bowl 2016. I don't know. Maybe we'll be opening another retail shop.
Thank you, Avery.
Thank you. Awesome. Thanks so much.
You can listen to an extended interview with Avery on our website, kamlashow.com, kamlashow.com. You can watch our TV interviews on our YouTube channel. And I'm on Twitter. My handle is @Kamla. If you have any questions, suggestions, or feedback, please feel free to send an email to us. And as always, thank you for tuning in.